Hello, this will be a tutorial on the basics of NeosVR controls and different functionality with them, like for Freecam for example. I'll have chapters in the video timeline if there's something specific you're looking for. But apart from that, let's get started. So start off with the basic move controls that can help with like adjusting things and so on. So facade to move around, shift to run, and with crouch, so that's C, if you just tap it, it will toggle it on and off. And if you hold down C, it will be as though it was a hold down. And another one that not many know about is if you press Z, it will turn into slow mode, which is useful when trying to move objects a small distance. And to get out of that, you can either run or press C again. Then for muting yourself in desktop mode, you can press M, and that will mute yourself like that. And while you're muted, if you press V, it will toggle on and off the mute. It will be a push or talk, sorry. And so, and then you can press M again to unmute yourself. Another one, if your computer or your keyboard has it, if you press page up, it will cycle yourself through the locomotions. So page up, and we'll just keep going until you're whatever one you want. But normally, if you to change locomotions, if you press down either your middle mouse button, or if you have a trackpad or something similar, you can press T. Now also open up your context menu. And then from here, you can go to locomotion and change to the one you want. Now for manipulating objects, to move them around, just right-click to grab them, and then hold down E to rotate them. If you need like a more control axis, just hold down shift, and then it will just spin around the Y-axis. And if you ever have something like off-skew and you want to straighten it, just grab it, and then click left click, and then it'll straighten it out. It's the same for inspectors, so you just click it, and then that's straight. Now for the tooltips, since desktop, it can be quite finicky to constantly spawn out of dev tip, or any other tips for that matter, and equip them, because there's nowhere on your avatar to store them. So what desktop has is, if you click any number on your number row, it will give you a specific dev tip, or tip in general. And then if you press 1, you'll get rid of that tip. So 2 is dev, 3 is logics, 4 is material, and then there's a couple others. I'll have a list in the description for the wiki page, so know which one's which. And then 1 de-equips. Although if you have a regular tip equipped, and you press 1, it will just de-equip it like normal, instead of deleting it like any of the number row tools will. Now, once you have a dev tip equipped, if anyone says like you need to press secondary for something, like when using logics or dev, that button is R. So if you press R, that will, with a dev tip equipped, it will make a gizmo, which you can then move it around and so on. And then to undo some action you've done, you can hit Control Z. And then to redo an action, hit Control Y. Now we start to go into Freecam. So for Freecam, this isn't quite free term, but if you ever need to have just a quick look at your avatar, you press F5, it will put you into third person mode, where you can just pan around your avatar, and when you try to interact with something, it'll move the camera out of the way of your avatar so you can see. Same goes for your context menu, we'll just put it up here. And although this doesn't quite let us inspect ourselves. So if you ever have an avatar equipped and you want to inspect yourself, instead of having to like very finically inspect your foot or something, if you press F6, it will put you into Freecam mode. And with this mode, we can then inspect our avatar and so on. To move around in here, what we need to do is hold Control and then click right click. And then you'll be able to pan around and move. Now, while you're in Freecam mode, people will see this little orb. People will also be able to hear you from here and your avatar. So depending on how far away you are from the avatar, or people are from your avatar, it will change the audio output. So if you're like all the way over here, people hear you from your Freecam instead of your avatar. Regular shift, Z does not work in Freecam, but shift for increased speed does. Although you do have to hold control whenever you're trying to move in Freecam, and you have to toggle it with right click, because otherwise if you don't hold control, you will just be stuck. And then while you're in Freecam, to move around your avatar, hold down left click, so your avatar will then point or look at that point, and then you can move as normal. Well, that will be based on what the direction of your pointer. So even though technically this is backwards from my viewpoint, W still moves me this way. You can also double click any direction to run in that direction, similar to like Minecraft or something. And then to go back from Freecam to your avatar, you can either press F6 again or F5. Either one works. We'll also remember your previous location of your Freecam. So if you have your Freecam on like some Logics or something, you go back, it will then take you right back there. So another thing before I get to focusing and panning around on Logics is focusing on individual objects. So let's say we have this cube here and we've inspected it, but we want to like pan around the object. So to do that, hold Control and then press F. And this will put us in the Freecam mode. You can also do this while you're in Freecam, just Control F again. And then while we're in Control F, we hold down Alt and then right click. This will allow us to pan around or orbit around the object, like similar to Blender or something. This can be on pretty much any object. So if, like, if I get this node browser, Control F on that, I will now orbit this. And then while I'm holding Alt and right click, if I scroll, I'll scroll in and out from that object. And to unfocus, Alt F, and that will unfocus you back to your avatar. Or you can press F5 or F6, and that will also put you back in the avatar. Now to focus on any object in a panel mode, to pan around objects and Logics. So we're going to inspect you out. So do that, just hit secondary, open the context menu, open inspector, and then it should pop up. And then once you have an inspector and you want to, instead of having to look around stuff, just hold left control, left click, and then this will snap you to the inspector. And then if you press hold control and hit right click once, like you would Freecam to move around, this will let you pan around the plane of the inspector. And this also works if I get, so if I press 3 and then get my node browser for my Logics, and I get Logics, these will all be perfectly planed. So instead of having to move around and look around stuff, you can just, if there's already some Logics out, you can hit control left click and that'll just snap to that Logics, or control left click on a node browser and that will also do the same thing, or inspector and so on. And depending on how close you are to the pane that you're snapped to will be determined if your view cam will appear or not, or the free cam. And this also works if you have someone like on a red print, for example. If there's some Logics out, you can control click on that Logics and that will then snap you to that Logics. Although do note, if you're working on a red print, whenever you spawn out a node, you will need to grab it and then let it go for it to snap to the node. It will be aligned perfectly, but it won't be parented under the red print. Also note, when you've snapped to some Logics or a inspector or something, that object determines where the pane of reference for your Freecam is. So since I've snapped to this Logics node, if I then move this, I will then move around. So be careful of that, because if you get some gizmos, don't control F onto the gizmo itself. Because if you control F into the gizmo, it will try and infinitely expand and then crash the game. Whenever you're in the panning mode, to exit the panning mode, you can either control click on like the horizon or any object that doesn't have a canvas on it, because that's what it determines what can be panned around. So you can just control it, click on like the horizon or something. Or you can click F5, or if you want to go straight to Freecam mode, you can click F6 and that will put you in Freecam. So then if you want to like go onto another object and then pan around and so on. I believe that's it, so hope this helps with getting used to desktop if that's all you have at the moment. It can be quite powerful, especially if you know how to use it well. There are some worlds that I might link in the description that I've built entirely in desktop if you want to take a look, but hope this helps, and maybe see you around.